Hi guys, it's Jeff here and welcome back to another episode of Skyblock, and we are just finishing off the last few challenges. If you remember in the last episode, we almost had enough to get the pumpkins finished, the jack-o'-lanterns I should say, so we're going to finish that with some torches here, and I think I needed another four jack-o'-lanterns, so I've got the last one there, and we also needed to make one more painting, so I'm going to make one last painting here. We do that with sticks all around the side and wool in the sander. Okay, so we've got our last painting. I'm going to put these in the trophy room just so I don't lose them. So I like to have everything nicely together. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pumpkins, 6 jack-o'-lanterns I should say. And I'm going to just place the other ones here. Let's see. We've got... Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'll stick it there. And the last one, where shall I put the last one? Maybe I'll stick it right here. Oh no, it's not going to fit there. Where can I put the last jack-o'-lantern? Somewhere a bit different. Okay, there we go. We got the last jack-o'-lantern sitting there. I wonder if I can remove this now. Yeah, I can. Okay. So we've got some nice jack-o'-lanterns on our balcony just to lighten the place up a bit. And that is almost all of the challenges. We've got a few left to do. One of them, which I'm going to tackle now, is the... Look at this sheep. He's just chilling out here. He escaped his pen. I wonder if I can get him back there. Probably not. The sheep... Oh, he went into the nether. The sheep went into the nether. Oh, no. Uh-oh. See if I can get him back. I might have to go and rescue this sheep. Okay, come on, sheepy. This way, this way. Come on, buddy. Follow me, follow me. Come on, buddy. Come on. Where am I? Oh, no. I died. Oh, no. No. I died. Oh, no. I died in the nether. Trying to rescue that sheep. Oh, I should have just left him there. Oh no, what am I going to do? I lost all my tools. I've lost everything. Oh no. I had stacks of wood on me as well. I don't have any axes. Oh no, I can't believe it. Okay, I'm going to steal this wood over here for a second. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe I lost everything there. I'm going to need an axe here. Let's grab this axe first off. I can't believe that. That's incredible. Okay, well, I'm just going to leave that sheep there. I'm not going to kill myself again. Chasing after that sheep. Silly sheep. Made me lose everything. Now, I'm going to need to grab my axe here. And anyway, hopefully it's not too important. I'm just trying to think what I had on me. I don't think I had anything on me that was absolutely crucial. I will need some more wood, though. So I'll just go and chop down these trees with my wooden axe now. And what we are going to do today is find a way to get these enderpearls. I do have a mob spawner up the top, which is spawning different kinds of mobs, but it doesn't spawn endermen, which I need for the enderpearl. So it's going to be a little bit tricky. I'm going to make another mob spawner just specifically for the enderman. So this one is going to be 3 blocks high. And hopefully we'll get a lot of endermen spawning there. And I'm going to have a little system where the mobs will flow towards me with a stream of water. And I'm going to have a bit of glass at the front so I can see them. And hopefully I'll be able to use my sword when I make a new one and kill the endermen. And hopefully they'll drop some enderpearls for me. And the other challenge I need to do is basically do a similar thing in the nether for the zombie pigmen, because I need to get the gold from the zombie pigmen when I kill them. So I need to collect some gold ingots, and I need to collect enderpearls, and I need to collect lots of wool as well. And as you can see, my sheep farm is going quite well. I'll just keep them going, and once I have enough sheep, then... Actually, I better grab some food while I'm here. Once I have enough sheep, I can use the wool to make the different dyes of the wool and make the last challenge. So the last few challenges are going to be quite difficult. I will have to just do the best I can to get them all done. Let's see if I can just replant these saplings here, because I may need some more wood a little bit later. I do have 18 pieces of birch here, so I might make this mob spawner out of I'll make it out of cobblestone and out of wood. I think I'll do both of those, just so I won't need to hopefully do more cobblestone mining. Okay, I'll just do it over here. If I can, I'll just be very, very careful. I can't believe I died trying to save that sheep. Not even sure how I died, really. So we're going to go 1, 2, let's see, 3, 4. Go out 10. Or thereabouts. We should be far enough. And it should be far enough away, I think, for the mobs to start spawning. Hopefully we will get lots of Endermen spawning. I haven't made this type of spawner before. And hopefully I will be able to kill the Endermen without them teleporting out as well. I don't want the Endermen teleporting everywhere and going aggro on me. So what I will do is just go to the side now, and we'll have, say, 3 blocks wide here. Just having a think about how I'm actually going to do this. We'll go like this, and let me think. The river is going to be on the ground level. So I'll leave that down here, the little river system. And I will have... Maybe I should just do the river system one wide, just to make it a small one. It doesn't need to be huge. All I need are 10 enderpearls. So it's not that much, really. But hopefully I'll be able to do that fairly quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... 7. And I might actually pause this video while I'm creating the base of this new mob spawner. So I'll be back in a second. Okay, so as you can see, I've done the base of the new Enderman spawner. I've made a little infinite water supply here just so I don't have to keep running back to the one way over there. So what I'm going to do, though, is place the water in these little channels here. And hopefully everything is going to start... working fine once I do this. So what's going to happen is the mobs will spawn on this platform. They'll fall into these little water streams here, including the Enderman, I'm hoping. And once they do that, they will get stuck in this water channel, and they'll flow all the way down. And I'm going to have a little block here where I can actually hit them, but they won't be able to hit me back. So I'm just going to leave their feet empty there, and I'll show you exactly what I mean by that in a second. But right now what I need to do is make the walls all around this, and it needs to be 3 high, and I need to make sure that I put some torches on top of the roof of this mob spawner, because I don't want the mobs spawning on top of the roof. That would be pretty bad, and yeah, I want to make sure that all of the mobs that spawn will be spawning inside this little structure. And hopefully we will get a lot of Endermen. So I'll be back in a second once I have done all of the walls around this mob spawner. Okay, so I've almost finished this mob spawner. I'm just finishing off the roof here. I've made all of the walls with whatever material I could find. As you can see, it's made out of all different kinds of things, but it doesn't really matter as long as it works. And I do hope it is going to work. I put a few torches in here just for now so mobs won't spawn while I'm still working on this. So once I close off this roof, it will all be pretty much finished, and I'll just take out these torches so that the mobs will start to spawn. And I am hoping that Endermen will spawn and that they will fall down the stream. I guess we'll just have to wait and see what happens. Hopefully it's all going to work properly though. So yeah, I guess we'll just have to wait. Now it's just a waiting game. What I will do though is put in a, let's see, a glass pane. Oh, maybe not there. Let's see, what shall I do? Oh, we'll just put something else here, like this, and I might actually remove this one here as well and make a little few bits of glass here just so I can see what's going on. It should still be dark enough. And when the mobs do come, I can attack their feet like this, and hopefully that will work. They won't be able to get away because the water will be keep pushing them into this glass. So hopefully it's dark enough in there for mobs to spawn. If it's not, I can remove this glass and put some cobblestone there instead. But I think it should be dark enough. I'll just have to wait and see. So while I'm waiting for that, I might go and feed these sheep again. And then we'll head off into the Nether. And we'll need to do something inside the Nether to allow the zombie pigmen to spawn. I think basically all we need to do in the Nether is make that space a bit larger so that they can actually spawn and give them... Oh God, can I close this? Why can't I close this gate? I can't close the gate. Ah, there we go. Okay. Whew. Now these sheep are absolutely going to mob me as soon as I pull out this wheat. There we go. Oh no. Stay back, stay back. Ah, I'm getting squashed. Oh gosh. These sheep are just squashing me. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's it. That's it, fellas. And what's this pig? This pig's hiding in the corner here. Poor little guy. Might as well extend our sugar farm a little bit as well. So make our sugar farm into a proper sugar farm there. And let's see. We'll get the melons. I do need some food. So grab a few more melons here while I've got the opportunity. And we'll better grab a little bit more wheat as well, just so we have something to feed the rest of the sheep. And it looks like they're trying to make their way through into the wheat farm. So hopefully they won't be able to get into the wheat farm and eat all the wheat when I'm not looking. So hopefully they behave themselves and stay where they're supposed to stay. Unfortunately, I'm not able to feed the little pig. There's only one of them. Do you want some food too, pig? Yeah, sheep. Pigs only eat carrots, unfortunately, and I don't have any carrots for them. So there's nothing much I can do about that. But I do have a little bit more wheat for these pigs over here, and hopefully I can feed all the ones that haven't been fed yet. So I'll just... Oh, there's a guy. How'd you get there, little guy? Oh, there's a little baby sheep appearing in my wheat farm. So I might have to get them back a little bit later. Okay, so they're treading all over my crops as well. Okay, do we have everyone? Has everyone eaten? Everyone had their wheat? Okay, I think that's pretty much just about everyone. Looks like they're starting to settle down now a little bit. And yeah, I think we've fed everyone there. So we'll head back now and have a look and see if any mobs are starting to spawn. Hopefully, I'll keep my fingers crossed, we will have some Endermen. And I forgot to put torches on the top of the roof. Oh no, I might have to wait for the daytime now. I might just go to sleep and wait for the daytime, because I don't want to deal with all of those mobs up there. Look at that. Look how many mobs there are up on top of the roof. There shouldn't be that many up there. They're supposed to be spawning inside the mob spawner, not on top of the mob spawner. So once daytime comes, I will put some torches up there and hopefully get rid of those mobs there. Then we'll head off into the Nether and do what we need to do in there. I will need to chop down a few more trees. Look at them all burning over there. Oh my goodness. Is there a Enderman up there? There is an Enderman. There's an Enderman outside. Oh my goodness. Oh no. Uh-oh. Don't look. Don't look at the Enderman. Okay. Yeah, so it didn't quite work out as I planned. They're throwing... Oh no. One of the guys fell off. One of my guys fell off. Oh no. I think they killed the Enderman though, or they pushed the Enderman off the edge. Oh, I see somebody there. I see some guys there. Who have we got? Who have we got in here? I don't know if the Endermen are actually going to teleport outside. But I can take out these guys. And the creepers shouldn't explode in there in the water. So that should be fine. I'll kill these guys and see who I've got left. I don't see any Endermen, which is a bit unfortunate. Where are the Endermen? Are there any Endermen in there? There's definitely lots of zombies and creepers and a few skeletons as well. Oh, he did get me. So I'll clear out these guys, and hopefully, once I get to have a look, I'll see some Endermen in there as well. Maybe they're just teleporting out, I'm not sure. If they are teleporting out, I'm going to have to come up with another plan. But definitely this mob spawner is working really well, as you can see. I've got a load of zombies. Is he getting out? No, I don't think he's getting out. Looked like he was getting out there for a second, but I don't think he is. Yeah, this mob spawner is just working really well. It looks like it's even working better than the one I made up top. The one up top only has a single stream. This one's got four streams, so should be a lot better than the other one I made. But unfortunately, I can't see any Endermen, and maybe the Endermen aren't trapped by the stream. And the spiders as well aren't going to fit down the stream. So, yeah, it looks like there is an endless spawn here of zombies and other critters. Oh no, oh no, oh no, they're all coming out! Oh no! Oh! Oh no! Oh goodness. that did not work too well. Oh no, it's a disaster. It's a disaster, what am I going to do? The Endermen are just teleporting out, and, oh no, Disaster, disaster. And they're just falling off now. No. At least I'll get to see if there's any Enderman in there. I can't see any Enderman in there, unfortunately. I don't know what I'm going to do now. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's all turned to chaos. Oh, that's a disaster. Oh, my goodness. Okay. I'm going to have to come up with another plan for the for the Enderman spawner. So, on that bombshell, I'm going to have to leave the episode here and have to go away and think about how I'm going to get these Enderman pearls. There is an Enderman right there, and was he going to give me an Enderman pearl? I doubt it. Maybe we can ask him for an Enderman pearl. No, I don't. Whoa! Oh no! Okay, he's not a friendly Enderman. I'm just gonna stay in here. I'm not gonna go anywhere. Looks like my my island's been taken over by mobs, and I don't know what I can do about it. So, yes, I'm just gonna hide in this house, and hopefully they'll go away. Anyway, that's all I have time for in this episode. I hope you're enjoying these series of videos. I'll see you all again soon. Bye for now. I'm just gonna hide.